started to believe the things they say of you. You really do believe this talk of God is true. And all of what you've done will soon get swept away. You've begun to matter more than the things you say. Listen, Jesus, I don't like what I see. All I ask is that you listen to me. And remember, I've been your...
Hello, everybody. It's me, Sean. I'm the ADHD philosopher. This is the pilot episode. We're going to call this one After the Memes. We're going to talk about what that even means, After the Memes. That's kind of like nonsense if you hadn't been, if you're not in my head. This is going to be a live broadcast show. Coming straight at you. Let me adjust the camera. I should have done that first. Oh, watch out. All right. So, this is what it is. It's kind of simple. I got access to music. I got access to videos. I can take live calls. What more do you need? I don't know. I got snacks. Snacky snacks. Drinky drinks. Let's start talking. I don't know. I might invite some people. People want to know about random crap sometimes. You never can tell what people want to know. Whoops. I'm also trying to record straight from the screen, so I just messed that up a little bit. I should be doing this over here. These are my things for taking calls. All right, it's going to be rough and tumble, but I'm ADHD anyway, so everything is. I'm just learning as I go. I'm going to refine this over time. 1 hour to play. 1 hour to talk. 1 hour to have fun. And see what happens. All right, I'm going to go ahead and get in here, look at myself. And hopefully not fall in love. Then I'm going to send some invites to some groups and some peoples. Share this. So some of you have been following along on my personal profile. And it looks like I've gone completely insane. Because my stream has just been not making any damn sense to anybody. But most of what I'm doing is putting together a postmodern method for assembling information into photo albums in Facebook. And that comes from philosophy, art, it's a whole bunch of stuff. And I totally understand, it looks crazy, but I figured my friends and family would be patient with me and let me explain later. And so here we are, and it's later. And part of what's going on is this show is going to help me promote the method that I'm developing for philosophy, and then political philosophy, and everything else. It's a way for me to publish my personal work through social media to reach my philosophy people, but it's also a way for me to do entertainment things, to do videos, to do YouTube channel. It's a whole lot of stuff rolled into one small package and a very low budget. Low budget. I already had all this stuff laying around. And as I played around with this method, I started discovering things about Facebook. I was like, I can do live broadcasts. I can take live calls. Well, heck, what else do you need? This is like a radio station right here. I might have to deal with some copyright stuff. I might have to deal with some lawyers calling up, but we'll see. I'm ADHD. We're just going to keep going until somebody stops me. And when they stop me, we're going to figure out how to get around them and keep going. Because I'm going to do what I want to do, and my goal is to be a professor teaching PhD-level philosophy in college, doing lecture circuits, writing books, and whatever it takes to get there and reach an audience and be able to just educate people and teach them about philosophy. And if they learn other stuff in the process and they're having fun, okay, I'm having fun. Let's all have fun. So, I got distracted. I'm still trying to send this invite. All right. I have a philosophy group in which I'm an admin. I'm one of 13. Hey, Jay, how's it going? You want to call in? You're on Messenger talking to me. Let me send this invite out. Do. Heck, I bet Jay's available. I'm going to call him if he don't call me. See what he wants to do about it. All right. Jay's in Great Britain, best of my understanding. I've got two people at least that I talked to over there. Let's see if he can call. Oh, call's going. Let's see if he answers. Oh, someone tried to answer. Is his mic working? We shall see. Yep. Tricky, tricky. We're learning on the fly here, Jay. Can you hear me? Because I know that we connected. There's a connection that's been made, and it's dropped. Call me back on that line, Jay. See if it works. Hard luck. Hard luck, Jay. Maybe something's going on in Great Britain. Let's see what else is happening. We got news. I could talk about news. Some man's accused of beating his girlfriend to death after her dad discovered whatever. I don't want to talk about that. Jay's calling. Hey, Jay, can you hear me? Oh, it's connecting. Connected and going. Jay, can you hear me? All right. I can't hear Jay. I assume he can hear me. Make sure I'm not muted. No, I shouldn't be muted. It worked with my wife. Got me all paranoid now. Okay, yeah. Jay's sending messages. He says he hears me. It's his end. Well, yep. Equipment problems. I can't help it when callers can't connect. I'm so sorry, Jay. I would love to talk to you. Keep working on it. Nobody else is trying to call in right now. My wife could. She's probably watching. Got some people in the thing. Who else here? Tiffany likes it. I don't know. Oh, no. Hate doing that. No, you didn't see what happened. I just threw some stuff up in my live video that I'm recording. All right. Now, once I got here, what do I want to do? Oh, yeah. We had a topic, didn't we? Always fall back on the topic I got set up, after the memes. So, the After the Memes project is my own personal project. It is a philosophy project. It's a method. So it's a It's a method to gather information and present it in one place. And that information, well, the presentation itself, it's a postmodernist presentation using Facebook's photo albums on your personal profile. And I'm trying to work out this method so you can just bring a huge amount. Okay, Jay's saying. All right, Jay's going to charge his phone instead of using his PC. That's cool. So he wants to know what the motivation for this all is. The motivation, really, Jay, is to have fun. I want to have fun. But at the same time, I want to produce videos that are 1 hour long that I can take pieces from and put on a YouTube. And those videos, I want them to have philosophy in them. So this is a philosophy talk show. If I get to speak and talk about philosophy in a way that educates and entertains live, I can get little bites, 3-minute videos, 6-minute videos, I don't know how long. Take those little bites, put those on my YouTube channel for philosophy, and try to generate an audience there. So ultimately, the goal is to build a social media presence and an audience. Get this audience so I can start talking about philosophy, because that's what I want to do with my life. I'm going to be going to grad school at University of Tennessee at Knoxville, where I'm going to apply and continue working on my philosophy degree. So I'm going to go the traditional academic route. But I'm also, at the same time, going to be working this social media angle. And a lot of what I'm doing is for my own personal research and empirical testing, because I'm really interested in Baladar's work and Derrida's work, the philosophers, both of them, with the simulacra, simulation, dissemination, and deconstruction with postmodernism. So it's a real postmodernist philosophy-oriented project that I'm doing here. This show is part of that entire project that I've labeled After the Memes, and it's found on my profile's photo album titled After the Memes. I don't know if you can understand anything if you try to read it, but if you go to my personal profile, you look at it, that's where all this information is being compiled as I develop this method. So, boring, right? That if I just talked about that all day, I'm going to lose half the people in the world, and I just, no one's going to want to watch that or be a part of that. But I've got an hour to work with in a talk show format, and I've got the entire internet at my fingertips in order to put this show on, I've got YouTube, I've got iTunes. I could play virtually any bit of music possible. Anybody who wants to can contact me. In the future, I'm going to be asking the UTC, University of Tennessee at Chattanooga's Philosophy Club, if they would like to group call and conference in with me. I'm going to be talking to the United Methodist Student Center on campus there, see if they'll let me sit in and conference call in on some of their meetings that they do, so that I can just participate and have that as part of my show. There's a whole lot of things. Talk to my wife if she wants to call in. I'm doing this during her downtime at work when there's nap time, and she can actually check in if she wants to. She's going to be part of my team. It's a really exciting thing for me. I didn't expect to be able to do this. I didn't realize I had the equipment. I didn't realize I had everything I needed to make this happen. Oh, so what do I mean by postmodernist? I've got Jay in Messenger, and he's asking me questions instead of asking them in the video, and that's fine with me too. Okay, postmodernist. It's a period of philosophy, and Jay is in the philosophy group, so he's interested in this kind of stuff, and he's over in Great Britain. You have modern philosophy, and if you remember, Wittgenstein was part of modern philosophy during that time period, and Russell was part of modern philosophy during that time period, and Russell the logician was getting on the radio, and he was getting on TV, and he's doing these interviews. You can find those interviews on YouTube if you want to look at Russell and his philosophy. He did a series on the BBC, I think, on the radio especially, Why I'm Not a Christian. Really controversial stuff. And he got a lot of attention for that. He attracted the attention of Wittgenstein. Wittgenstein came in and became his student. And nobody knew Wittgenstein was this billionaire from Austria, just looking like he was a crazy man that wandered off the street into the university to talk to Russell. He was attracted by Russell using the radio. And then that's how we got Wittgenstein. If you know anything about him, he's a big deal. So from there, the period keeps going, and you get Michel Foucault, you get Sartre, Heidegger, the existentialists. They all start moving down that road. Simone, well, let's not forget the women. Simone's in there, too. She did a lot of good work. And we lead all the way up to Baladard and Derrida. And they did the major things that got me into this whole postmodernist philosophy phenomenon. And Baladard said that technology has gotten to the point where our brains and our consciousness is having trouble distinguishing between reality as a physical material thing and reality as what's being shown to us on media, social media, videos, movies. So our brains are just starting to meld these two realities into one. And that's postmodernism. It really started to pick up and gain momentum in art and literature. Derrida, especially, he's the guy, Derrida, just right there, just made it a thing. It crystallized around this guy. So if you look on YouTube, and you look on YouTube, you can find videos of Derrida speaking. He's speaking in French in most of the interviews. You can find these interviews, see what he says, you can read his books. I'm not going to go over all that here. It'll be too boring and too academic. We got lots of academic people on YouTube that'll tell you everything you want to know. You have any other questions I can do for you? For me, my personal life, my personal experience, I knew what postmodernism was when I was a teenager, but back then it was architecture. That's all it was. People building buildings in an artistic style. They went from the modern architecture to the postmodern architecture. I guess Derrida picked that word up, used it, and artwork started following Derrida and being inspired by what he said. So they started using surreal techniques. It's a presentation of multiple themes in this layered layer in art. So you might have a painting, and it has a classical style to it, but then all of a sudden it's got modern things going on, and then it has some abstract stuff in it. And these different styles layered into one presentation became a postmodern style in artwork. And then it jumped out of artwork and went into literature, and Derrida himself used it. He would write, he'd experiment with this stuff. He would write on the left column this one article and on the right column a fiction story. And simultaneously, both things are talking about similar things. You can't tell which one's this academic article and this fiction story, melding together in this presentation, and he started playing a lot of games with words and messing with a lot of people's minds. And that's how he inspired Baladrar to just continue on with his work. And now it's snowballed into what the media is calling the post-truth era. Here we are now. Like, in the best of my ability, looking around, maybe 90% of the people living and acting politically and doing things have no idea what postmodernism is. But it's what's driving their political rhetoric. It's what's bringing them the news through the media. It's what's teaching them what they want to know about the world and informing them without them even being aware of how it works and what's being done. So you got all kinds of different groups in power trying to compete with each other using postmodernist methods and rhetoric and art to get your attention. I think people should know about that. People, politically especially, should know what's going on so they can know whether or not they're being manipulated or subverted. And when they're trying to say their things on Facebook, somebody comes in, throws internet memes at them, subverts their message. It gets kind of crazy. All right. So I've just dealt with Jay's questions, and I'm available for more fun. That's why I'm here, personally. Me, that was the most fun thing that happened to me ever, right there. It was great. But in the meantime, we can look around. We can talk about politics. We can talk about people being crazy. Let's get back to the After the Memes project. So, what it all started out with is, let me tell you a story. We'll tell a story time right now. When I was young, up in the, teens, 20s, I don't even remember exactly when it was. I just remember it happened. I was arguing. I was just running my mouth. You know, people who know me know I'll argue. I loved arguing, even back then. I loved arguing when I was a kid. I was arguing with what was pretty much a PhD in literature, and postmodernism was his thing. That's what he loved. And he had studied Derrida, and he had studied deconstruction and dissimulation. And he knew the postmodernist literary and rhetorical argumentation styles, the methods. I was arguing with him. He blew my mind. He just exploded everything I even knew about what arguing was. He did that whole thing. Truth is subjective. He basically presented Derrida's work to me, but didn't even tell me what it was. So it really messed my mind up. I could not have any faith in language and words and truth. And I was like, what the hell just happened? Because in my heart of hearts, I believe that there is an objective reality. There is an absolute truth. But now, I couldn't express it. It was gone. The ability to even think about truth the way I used to was completely destroyed for me personally. And that's what got me into philosophy. I was already doing philosophy from an Eastern perspective with martial arts. I was already, you know, slightly interested in those kind of things, but just not really motivated to study it. But when this man blew my mind and I lost all sense of faith in words and truth, I had to figure out what the hell just happened. Not only because I was confused and lost, you know, existential crisis and stuff, but also because I wanted to be able to argue like that. That guy whipped my ass, and I had no say in how to argue back. I was just like, what's going on? What's happening to me right now? And what's he doing? Whatever he's doing, he's beating the hell out of me in this argument. So I wanted to both know what that was, how to get my faith back into language and truth, and how to counteract what that jerk did to me. So here we are today. 15 years of study to finally figure out that Derrida was the one that started it. Postmodernism was the political philosophy that was doing it. And then I finally identified the exact specific areas that were the problem for me personally, which I resolved. I've resolved these problems. Now I'm working on my own work. That's what After the Memes project is. I'm doing my own work now. Philosophically. This is going to be the stuff I'm going to probably spend the rest of my career doing. So, that's it. Awesome. Good question. That's why I'm doing this, too. I love talking to people. I love good questions. I love all kinds of stuff. I love my wife. She's probably watching every once in a while, or she will later. All right. Now I'm kind of losing the momentum. I'm going to look around, see what else is up. Stephen Colbert mocks Trump for Meryl Streep comment. Well, Trump deserves to be mocked. Oh, my wife's Facebook Live froze on her. That was a notification, what you just heard there. She sent me a message through the phone service. I can't get those messages, baby. That's all right. What else is going on in the news? And y'all like Stephen Colbert? I like Steve Colbert. I think he's hilarious. I used to watch him and John Daly every once in a while. I've just been doing other things, lost track of it. Don't watch it so much anymore. Let's see. I'm trying to surf the internet on this computer here, this MacBook, but I'm going to switch over to the iPad to surf the internet. Since I'm recording video live on the MacBook, it's presenting a challenge for surfing the web. Let's look at some of this and that. Oh, internet memes. Oh, here's my son. Hey, boy, what's up?
Nothing.
You want to come over here and say hi? You want to step over that cord? Don't unplug it. Can you do that? Don't jump. Oh, you did jump and you made it. All right, come here. Oh, we got our dog over here, too. The whole family's coming over. Excellent. It's my boy, Jacob. He's pretty awesome. Aren't you? You see yourself?
Yeah.
You're not going to be able to hear yourself, so don't try to do that. Oh, you dropped your dog, doll. All you have to do is say hi. I'm not going to let you sit here the whole time. Say whatever you want to say. You can look at it later. Jacob is a YouTuber. He loves to watch YouTube videos. He loves to play video games. But he's also, like his daddy, ADHD, so he's looking around and distracted. Will you go play? Can you go play?
I just want to do some YouTube videos.
We'll do some later, okay?
I promise. Okay.
All right, awesome. Watch out for this cord. Let me know if you need anything, all right? Don't jump this way. No, I want you to step over slow. You jumped the first time and you made it. This time, you want to step on out. Awesome!
Probably, right?
Probably. Thank you very much.
Probably.
I really had a good time. All right, so I'm in my kitchen, in my living room. This entire production cost me zero extra money. This is money I've already put into the electronic toys that I love. Like I said in my intro promo video, I'm using an iPhone 6S on a tripod to stream the live video. That's what's picking up the sound that you're hearing. I'm using a MacBook to watch the live video stream for the comments with it muted. And I'm also recording it from the screen caps using QuickTime app. I've got the iPad Pro here. And it's got the signal splitter right here, so the one goes to the microphone so I can talk, and one goes to a speaker through an auxiliary cable so that you can hear who I'm talking to. And when nobody's talking to me, I'm using the iPad to just look through a feed, look the internet, see something I want to talk about. Over here on the MacBook, I've got access to the iTunes. And my entire iTunes library. That's Jesus Christ Superstar right there. What's the bug? That's going to be my intro music. If you really pay attention to the lyrics in this intro, nice little spot.
My mind is clearer now.
My mind is clearer now.
At last,
all too well,
I can see where we all will soon be,
and that's it. That's
you strip away.
That's the message I want to send for my intro to this show. So that's just the intro music right there. This postmodernist, post-truth world that we're living in with social media, politics, news, is traumatic. But I'm real good at philosophy, real good at politics, apparently, since now that I'm looking into political philosophy and studying it for the last 6 months. Good at that. I know what's going on. I see what they're doing and how they're doing it. I'm just a jack of all trades with ADHD that loves philosophy and just wants to get stuff done. So that's what we're doing. All right. It's 1:54. We've got 36 minutes left in this broadcast. I got to stick to a schedule or I'm just going to go crazy and broadcast for 42 hours and look like a madman and a conspiracy theorist. Anybody talking? Anybody checking? All right. I'm going to look around, see if there's anything else cool going on. Let me see if I can stream some music through YouTube real quick. I want to see if I can do YouTube videos with this iPad and if you can see them. Let's try out... Oh, yeah, I know what to try. I know what's entertaining for me. I know what I want to do. Excellent. There it is. It's going to be a surprise. Uh-oh. Lost the sound. I might need a new speaker, babe. I'm going to have to buy that.
Oh, God, you guys. This had better be pretty freaking important. Is the meadow on fire?
No, Charlie. We found a map to Candy Mountain. Candy Mountain,
so
Charlie.
Charlie. We got a video I want to talk Candy about. Mountain. I could do this right here.
Come with us, Charlie.
Something news-wise.
Yeah, Charlie. It'll be an adventure. We're going on an adventure, Charlie.
Yeah, Candy Mountain, right. I'm just gonna, you know, go back to sleep now.
I sit here and make faces.
Oh, Charlie, you have to come with
nice.
Us to Candy Mountain.
Nice.
Yeah, Charlie.
I'm experimenting with this as I go. So, I can do that. If we got something political, something topical that's on YouTube we want to talk about, we can talk about it. Excellent. Here, let me give you a little something right here. This is my favorite part of this whole video.
We're on a bridge, Charlie.
This is called Charlie
We're
the
here.
Unicorn.
Well, what do you know? There actually is a Candy Mountain.
Uh-oh.
Candy Mountain, you fill me with sweet sugary goodness. Go inside the Candy Mountain cave, Charlie.
Here it comes.
Charlie.
Here comes my favorite part
cave.
Of this entire video.
Magical wonders are to behold when you enter.
Yeah, thanks, but no thanks. I'm going to stay out here.
But you
Uh-oh.
Have to enter the Candy Mountain candy cave, Charlie.
When you're down and looking for some cheering up, then just head right on up to the Candy Mountain Cave. When you get inside, you'll find yourself a cheery land. Such a happy and joy-filled and perky merry land. They've got lollipops and gummy drops and candy things. Oh, so many things that will brighten up your day. It's impossible to wear a frown in Candy Town. It's the mecca of love, the Candy Cave. They've got jelly beans and coconuts with little hats. Candy rats, chocolate bats. It's a wonderland of sweets. Ride the candy train to town and hear the candy band. Candy bells, it's a treat as they march across the land. Cherry ribbons stream across the sky into the ground. Turn around, it astounds, it's a dancing candy tree. In the candy cave, imagination runs so free. So now, Charlie, please, will you go into that cave?
Alright, fine, I'll go into the freaking candy cave.
Go into Plato's cave. Because that's what the Candy Mountain cave is right there. Charlie the Unicorn going on into Plato's cave. And he's going to get something happen. If you want to watch that, it's on live. It's on YouTube. It's called Charlie the Unicorn. What's going to happen? No spoilers. Some of these people might not know what happens. Let them find out, okay? My son was about to tell you what happens. We're streaming live, Jacob, okay? Anything you say, everybody can hear. Is that okay? You understand? Awesome. Don't cuss. You're going to make me look like a bad parent if you do. And your mama will get real mad at me.
It's just as Kenny gets taped.
No spoilers. You can't tell them what happens. It's on YouTube. It's called Charlie the Unicorn. It's like a 5-episode series. Please go play. I know you're going to spoil it for everyone if I let you. Awesome. Thank you, baby. All right. So I could do all kinds of stuff right there. That alone opens up doors. Doors everywhere. News. I can go to news places. I can criticize politics. I can do anything I damn well please. If you can see that, we could talk about it. We're going to get stuff done. We got music. We got entertainment. I got the internet. What more could you possibly want in a show? And it don't cost me a penny to produce this. Good work, Sean Kerrigan. Pat on the back. Tippity clap. All right, it's 1:59. We got 31 minutes left in the show. Anybody else want to talk about something? Because if you don't tell me what to talk about, I'm just going to keep entertaining myself. Talk about what I feel like talking about. But remember, this is an interactive show. Interactive. You can ask questions. I'm an expert on damn near everything. If you ask my wife, she'll tell you. But I'm really, really good expert on philosophy. So if you got a philosophy question, we'll get it done. We'll talk about it. I like literature too. Uh-oh. Jay Johnson, gonna try again. Hey, can you hear me? Oh.
I think.
Yeah, hey, I hear you.
How you doing, man?
I'm doing good, how are you?
I'm all good, you know, I've been watching your live show, it's quite entertaining, I've got to say. Philosophy's an old subject, it really is.
Nice. Oh, you want to introduce yourself, because you are streaming live right now. Oh, I think I might just...
Yeah, sure, I'm...
Hold on a second, will you do me a favor?
I'm trying, man.
Will you do me a favor?
Yeah, sure.
Will you call me right back? Because I just disconnected you from my technical error. I made a mistake. Call me right back, okay? Oh, I'm sorry, Jay. I hit a wrong button. That was a mistake. I'd probably fire myself if I was interviewing myself. But I'm not. Cool. So, that's Jay. Jay Johnson from the United Kingdom. He's all the way overseas at an island. Talking to me on the internet. Now, I really want him. I'll call him back. He ain't calling me back, so I'll call him back. I can do that. I just realized that. I'm going to push my glasses up. Does this look cool? Is this a cool thing? I might start doing that. Push my glasses up. Oh, he called me. We're crossing lines. All right, Jay. Sorry about that. Won't happen again.
Got it, bro. It's all right, man.
Awesome. I'm going to have to check the sound levels. I'm going to have to check the sound levels later after the show. So you might be too loud, but we'll figure it all out. Will you introduce yourself? You're going to be live right now.
Yeah, sure. My name's Jamie Johnson. I use the name Jay on Facebook. I'm from the UK. Really, I got into philosophy by reading a lot about existential nihilism. And for me, that was because of, the science behind the end of the universe.
Right.
And that, it sort of really changed my perspective, really. Just, I feel as if everything around me is sort of temporary, and having that sort of feeling, it sort of messes with your head a little bit.
Oh, yeah. I went through that. I went through a nihilist phase while I was in the Navy. So, we had some trouble.
How did you get out of your phase, really? Because for me, I'm still going through it right now.
Well, I just kept living. I think I almost got beat to death once. Almost died about 7 times. I don't know if you want to go through the same thing I did. It's a process. Each person experiences it differently, dealing with some of the existential angst. You might do well reading. I mean, once I got into reading existentialism, it helped me process some of those things out a little more... intellectually instead of viscerally. So back then I wasn't reading much philosophy. I was just trying to work things out through trial and error and alcohol and other things. I don't recommend that route to anybody.
I suppose, being honest, I think I should probably read more philosophy. I think I'll just sit back, smoke weed, and then I'll just sit back and think about laws.
Yeah. We've got that.
The best thing for me.
I don't even know what that is. That your notifications going on, or is that mine? Little vibrations.
I think that was mine then.
Okay, it's no problem. I just want to know what it is. It'll drive me crazy if I keep thinking about it.
Did you just hear it again?
Yeah. It's an interesting sound.
My phone, my bad. My phone weren't working really. It's sort of shitty, isn't it? How you doing, guys, anyway? Hi, live stream.
Jamie says, hi, live stream. We're talking about the marijuana. We're starting to legalize that in the United States. You're starting to see it being legalized. So your experience and what you're talking about is going to be a more common thing going on. So do you want to talk more about how your daily life and reading philosophy and experiencing that and smoking marijuana actually just affects you, how you experience that?
I'll tell you this about weed and marijuana. When you're smoking weed, when you come on your come down, It increases the chance of you developing something called depersonalization disorder.
Mm-hmm.
And you begin to feel really disconnected from everything around you. You start sort of, you just feel in a little bubble, if that makes sense. Sometimes everything around you just sort of seems a bit hazy. You know, weed works differently with different people, but this is how it's impacted me personally. And I can honestly say weed has changed my life so much. The way I think about things is different.
Right.
The way I think about morality and how I act to others is different, you know.
Do you think it was different before, or is it because of the substances? I don't know. I can't handle any kind of experimentation or use of marijuana. My brain is not set up to handle that experience and have it be positive for me in any way. It's really awful for me, and I'm glad nobody else experiences what I did.
So you've smoked weed before, yeah?
Oh, yeah. I mean, especially now that it's been legalized, and you know, I've been places where it's legal, and, you know, you get curious, and it's not against the law. You're going to try it out, right?
Yeah, of course, man. I mean, you know, I'm actually so glad that weed has become, well, it's becoming normalized in the United States, and that has a national effect over in America, but of course it also has an international effect. You know, it leads to the normalization of weed use all over the world, really. I mean, people from all over the world are looking at that, and they're going to be influenced by what America decides to do.
That is true. And since we've got, well, I don't even remember how many states right now that have full-on legalized recreational use, that momentum is starting to just keep going. It's going forward. You got people that are starting to use it medicinally. They don't have to get a prescription. They're just going into their local place. They're picking up the high cannabinoids with the low THC and just using it therapeutically without any prescription. Hey, go ahead. You were going to say something?
Yeah, they use it's the CBD in the plant. It's that medicinal users really want. I can't remember what it stands for, but I know it's got several medicinal properties. You know, it's the THC that's the psychoactive part in the weed. It gets you high, you know.
Hey, can I take a moment right now to go ahead and just...
Hey, man, before you leave, I got to get you to...
Can I stream the audio to a video on YouTube? The title is "Watch Snoop Dogg Smokes Weed and Freestyles on Air." It was shared by the Huffington Post. Can I do that? Of course I can. I'm going to.
Yeah, sure, man.
All right, let me pause.
You're the host here, bro.
Let me pause and play this and see what the audio sounds like. I just want to see it myself. I've never seen it.
Do one thing.
It.
What you want? I need a Huff Post live freestyle, man.
For real?
I need a Huff Post live freestyle.
Give me a beat.
It's Snoop Dogg, I'm huffing and puffing.
That's it? That ain't it.
This ain't that. The other one.
The other beat, man. The one before that or after that.
So apparently Snoop Dogg is, you know, he's high right now on the interview.
Yo,
they're having some production problems.
I got a lighter, don't trip.
Good. I see how you reach for that motherfucker.
You know what? I was reaching to throw it away.
No, you weren't. You reach for that motherfucker, you reach for that to be lit.
Spark it. I'm just saying.
I know how motherfuckers reach when they throwing it away. Throw away ain't that way. Throw away is that
I don't
way.
Touch this stuff, man.
You didn't throw that away. First time ever on the Huff Post.
Yo, he's smoking.
Alright, so Snoop Dogg. In this video, smoking weed right on the video live. Obviously, this is somewhere that is illegal.
It's too late to put it out.
I shared that video to my live stream comments.
It's too late to put it out. Let's go. Call your people from the third floor and let them know. Let them know. Get the fire extinguisher. I didn't mean to, but I had to.
Let's go. You got the beat?
All right, he's about to freestyle.
Got the beat? Come on. We might have to do this acapella. What'd you say? All right, that's the beat we got, dog.
Oh, they ain't that working?
That's all we got. That's all. Yo, we on live TV right now, dog.
Man.
Yo, Okay, hold on. Turn it up a little bit. Turn it up. Let me hold this for you. Yeah, damn, scavenger. Come on. Let's go.
Okay, that was... That was for fake, but this is for real. You take the blunt and let me tell him the deal. Big Snoop Dogg on the Huffington Post.
Here we go.
I represent nothing but the Wild West Coast. I sit in my seat. I bob to the beat. I look to the left and there's a room full of freaks with glasses on looking like Lois Lane. I'm your Superman. Let me do my thing. Let me fly through the sky. Let me stay fly. They call me S-N-O-O-P D-O-double-G-Y D-O-double-G. But then I drop the G-Y. Now they call me S-N-O-O-P L-I-O-N. That's me. On to the record though. Sitting with my nephew as he holding on my chromosome. Give it back to me. Let me hold it. I won't smoke it. I promise. I know the people watching at home. They getting excited because they know I might hit it. But if I hit it, I'm going to get you in trouble. I can't do it, but I did it. Get it. Take it back from me and let me run it to him. You sucker, you a dummy. You watching at the pad, getting mad, getting happy. Snoop is on the mic, tell your mama and your pappy how I roll. With Laker on my chest, oh yes, Huff Post. You know how we do, we represent and we brag and we boast. Grab your glass of toast. Snoop Dogg is the coldest from the West Coast. Hello.
That was good. I respect Snoop Dogg. He can rap. I've always liked him, but that was an impressive video for me. That's videos on YouTube. By Huffington Post, it's Snoop Smokes Weed and Freestyles on Air, and I linked it into my live stream here. What you think about that video, Jay?
You know what? I think Snoop Dogg's got some great lyrics, you know. He can just think of anything on the spot.
He's pretty genius. Yeah, he's one of the top geniuses I've seen lyrically and flow and freestyle. I like him. Like him a lot. So what else are we going to talk about? Well, let's not make it a weed show. We got a philosophy show, too, to do. Oh, excuse me.
You could go on about political philosophy, if you want.
Oh, would you like to know about political philosophy? Well, I started studying political philosophy 6 months ago, and I'm reading a book called The Blackwell's Companion to Contemporary Political Philosophy. That's the book I started reading. I'm only halfway through it. And the sections, the analytical philosophers, it just goes section by section with an academic article, like a journal article, and it has all the citations, all the references, and all the further reading recommendations. All these people got credentials, and they're professors in different universities. It gives you all that information. And I started studying that, and I started seeing things that really are going on in politics, and I understood it. And I was like, oh my gosh, this stuff's crazy, y'all. It's wild. It's just some wild stuff. And since you're in the United Kingdom, I'm not 100% sure how it's set up institution and organization-wise with politics compared to U.S., but the theories and the philosophies that are going into it are real similar. So when I started...
Yeah, incredibly similar, yeah. I'd say over in the U.S., I'd say politicians are a lot more vocal about each other. You know, in the UK, they tend just to talk about the issues at hand a lot more. But the in-sport matches going on between Hillary and Trump, that was just crazy, to be honest. You know, puts things into perspective for me, about the differences between just the political philosophies between two different countries. It's mad.
Yeah, what is your impression over in the UK? How old are you right now? And what's your impression of the what we had was the primaries, the caucuses, the two nominees, and now we had the presidential election and general election, and then we elected Trump. That's all over with now. He's about to go into office. What's your impression, and how old are you over there in Great Britain?
To be honest... You know, I always wanted Trump to win, not based on his sort of...
My wife's not going to like that. My wife's
what he said in the way, or loyal to Trump based on his character. You know, in a way, he really got me in because I didn't care about what he said at all. You know, he was just entertaining.
Right.
And I think that's why a lot of people voted for him, just because he's quite vocal, he's a male leader. He presents himself in a very confident way, and look, I think confidence is what people want to see a lot of the time. You know,
I'm going to have to come back to this male leader. I'm going to have to interrupt you for a second. You're going to have to talk more about what you meant by male leader, because My wife's not going to let that one go. She's going to know. She's going to want to know. She's a feminist, and she's very passionate about feminism. I'm not, so that causes some tension in the house. But she's going to want to know what you meant as a British young man about him being Trump being a male leader.
Okay. Well, what I meant by that was he shows a lot of masculinity in what he says. You know what I mean?
Oh, I know what you mean, but I want to know what you're saying. I'm not actually trying to give you a hard time. I'm just really interested in you explaining what you're trying to say, so I want to hear how it comes out and how it plays out.
I don't think I used the word masculine correctly, to be honest. I meant masculine. Oh, no, I didn't use masculine correctly, to be there. That was not the word I was looking for. More bad, bro.
I'll just keep trying. I'm going to mute my mic for a second so I can talk to the camera, but I'm not going to say anything bad about you. Hey, you got to let people have a chance to explain themselves. You can't just jump on them and get mad at them. When you're doing philosophy especially, you want to know what they're saying. You got to connect. All right. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you, bro.
All right. So, yeah, keep going. Are you struggling with that word masculine? Because it sounds right. I mean... Oh, no, the dogs. Stop stomping, please. But, yeah, Trump is hyper-masculine. Yeah, go ahead.
What people wanted was a sort of leader who asserted a lot of confidence. And the way Trump goes about himself, he makes it as if he will get what he wants. And people want someone... You will not settle for anything less. You know what I mean? And Trump does that in a very nice way. He just... I don't know what else to say about Trump. He's just a funny character.
Oh, yeah.
I think people just love that.
I can understand being amused. I'm just going to use the anecdotal stories about it. Like, my wife is not amused. Not funny. She's not happy at all. And I know my aunt's not either. Me... I've never been into politics. It's just never been something I'm passionate about. I'm really interested in it, want to know how it works. I love studying it. So I'm really detached and impersonal about what's going on. I don't have any passion. But my wife makes up for that. She's got all the passion this family needs about politics. So I've got that there. You know, she's not going to be happy that someone from Britain has an opinion about Trump that sounds positive. I don't mind. He is funny. He's amusing. I'll give you that. And if I...
Look, it's scary at the same time. He has caused a lot of global tension. I'll say that.
Right, right. So, on the other hand, there was the Hillary. There was Bernie Sanders. All that stuff was really interesting. We're talking about political philosophy. So, when I was looking at that, one of the things I noticed is what's going on, especially now that... After our reading about contemporary political philosophy through the Blackwell guides, what we're seeing, I'm starting to see that there are so many groups vying for attention in the media, but also on social media and everywhere. And these groups are using different narratives. They're using different methods to try of rhetoric and media and whatever they're trying to do. They're trying to gain influence in the political discourse and trying to gain momentum in getting power and access to it. And so, you know, you've got your liberals who really felt the blow of this election. It's a blow to the ego. It's a blow to morality. And when I say morality, they're moral. They're morale. They're taking a morale blow. They're really just trying to recover from this, shocked and stuff. You got the conservatives, and my impression is, in the United States, a great majority of the conservatives have no idea how this happened, that Trump just kept going with it and kept going and gained the momentum and got into the office, got elected, and they're happy about it. They're working with it. They're trying to get their angles in, but that's what attracted me to actually studying political philosophy. The project I'm working on after the memes, how the 2016 presidential election ate my face. That's what the full title of the work's going to be. That's what got me into politics. I had to figure out what happened. Go ahead.
Yeah, you mentioned different political narratives earlier, and that's quite an important point about narrative, actually. Have you noticed how Trump's narrative has changed throughout his campaign?
Oh, I have noticed. I've been watching careful. I've been taking notes.
Yeah, well, at the start, what Trump was doing was he was intentionally making racist comments. Well, I wouldn't say racist. He was intentionally making very controversial comments.
I'm going to have to do something about that.
This was because the media was just blowing up. He was gaining free publicity.
Yeah.
So he's attracted so much attention to himself, and the media just keeps eating and eating and eating. And in that way, it actually pushed his campaign forward.
Hey, could you give me a second, please? All right, hold on.
Yeah, sure.
Jacob, buddy. Jacob. What? Quit taunting that dog. You're making her bark. Stop knocking on things, okay? Please. Please, pretty please. With sugar on top. I'm trying to do. I've got what? I've got 10 more minutes, and then you can play all you want with the dog. All right, I'm back. I'm back. I really appreciate you calling in, Jay. It really helps me out today. It really helps me, just do the show. This is a good pilot, as far as I can tell.
Yeah, man, it's been a nice experience, bro.
Yeah, I love it. Any more things on your mind? I got 10 minutes to wrap up the show. I think I'm going to wrap up the call and then just wrap up the rest of the show.
I've got my dinner downstairs, so it's been nice speaking to you, Zane, bro.
What time is it over there?
I don't actually know. Give me a sec. It's about 20 past 7 over here in the UK.
Oh, that's pretty cool. That's a good time period. Me and the UK might get along during this time period, this one-hour show period. All right. Well, thanks for calling in. Thanks for talking to me. I really appreciate it.
All right, man. Cheers. See you later.
See you later. All right. That was Jay Johnson. Called me from AOL Messenger with a voice call on my iPad. You see how that works? That's it. That's the pilot. This is what I'm trying to show everybody. And that's awesome. I'm so happy with that. So all of that was unscripted, off the cuff. I'm just using my brain to remember things and then just talking about stuff. Did you like the Snoop Dogg? Personally, I do like Snoop Dogg. I've always been a fan of him. I like his work. I like him. He's got a good personality. He's hilarious. Have you ever seen his Facebook videos? No, not Facebook. He's not on Facebook doing videos. YouTube. Let's look at one of those before we leave. We got 8 minutes. We're going to wrap it up. We're going to look up on YouTube, Snoop Dogg narrates Planet Earth. I'm going to go through there. If you haven't seen this, it's hilarious. Let me bring it up. Let me pause it. Let me full screen it. Jacob, boy, please, please give me 8 more minutes. All right. My son's in there fighting with that dog and saying, ow. Jacob, stop. This is Snoop Dogg on YouTube.
Hey, it's your boy, Big Snoop Dogg. Let's look at some animals. Here we go, we got flamingos, right? Them is flamingos. I know what flamingos is, because they pink. What's wrong with him? Oh no, cuz the alligators is camouflage. The alligators got green grass on their head and flamingo slipping off the rock, cuz if he fall, his ass is grass. Look at this motor mouth under the water. Oh, that's cool. He throw. Flamingos can't fly, huh? His ass is falling. He falling real fast. Uh-oh. Look at this. Oh. You better keep it moving, because you flat.
I might yell at my son. Don't be traumatized if I do.
He got walked down by a gator. Life and death. That hurt. Roll the footage. As you see right here, we have a big... What is that, a pigeon? What is that, a goat? Oh, they only, cuz. He got two birds. They circling in the goat, cuz. He trying to get out of there. He ain't got nowhere to hide, cuz. They got two. What is them, hawks? Oh, they on the go, cuz. They chasing me, cuz. Oh, no, he can't get away. He got those moves. Jump. Dip, Jacob. Slip.
He running from a bird, cuz. I hope that bird catch you and eat you. That was running hard. He was running like OJ on the Hearst commercial through the airport.
Hey, what were the funniest, man? Let me see what we got up here. Wildebeest. Crocodile. Oh, I like this kind of they down there sipping water in the wash.
So if you want to watch the rest of that video, that's on YouTube. That's Snoop Dogg narrates Planet Earth. Like a true OG. That's the whole title of that one. Snoop Dogg narrates Planet Earth like a true OG. I'm going to write that down. So I said I like Snoop Dogg. I've listened to him for a long time. I've enjoyed rap since I was about 20. That's when I really got into it. I really got into it when I had a roommate and a best friend named Greg in Washington. We ran around to the hip-hop clubs. Did all kinds of good fun time stuff. Snoop Dogg narrates. All right. Oh no, what happened here? I just moved my video by accident. That's weird. All right, whatever. We'll work that out in post-production. Post-production. I'm like a professional, y'all. Well, we got 4 minutes. We're going to wrap it up, and that'll be the episode for today. My wife didn't call. You going to call, baby? If you see this and you're watching, call me up. We'll say goodbye. Wait, I might have lost my headset. All right, listen. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this for entertainment's purpose. This is not serious. I'm going to be real loud. Are you ready? Now I want you to understand. I'm just playing around, and my son knows that. Jacob! Be quiet for 4 minutes, please! Please! Okay? 4 minutes. All right. I had to set that up. Somebody's going to clip that out, and it's going to look crazy. Go watch TV, and then we're going to play. We're going to play for an hour, 2 hours. I hope you parents have good kids that are as awesome as my son is. All right. What time is it? 3 minutes. This last 3 minutes is twisting my head a little bit because I don't want to stop. But I'm going to have to. I'm going to get some olives. I'm going to stress eat. Calm down a little bit. Except that I have to end the show. Maybe get a gummy worm. And then try to figure out. Alright, I'm going to have to plan out an ending. This hanging, trying to figure out what to do in the last minute, that ain't going to work out for me. I'm stressing out too much. I've got the hat in my profile picture. It's a tribute to the Catcher in the Rye. This is the hat. You see my profile picture. J.D. Salinger, Catcher in the Rye, Holden Caulfield. That's what that is. It's a tribute. The quote in my profile picture is straight out of Catcher in the Rye. All right. I got this board here. Now, let me tell you what. I'm just going to toss this out. Facebook Messenger, you can send money to people. You send me a donation. You want me to write something? I don't care if it's 10 cents or more. You send me a donation. Tell me what to write on this board. I'll write it. And I'll show it to the camera. And if you say a specific amount of time, like you want me to put it up on here, put it on the wall. I might get another whiteboard behind me. Put it like an advertisement. We'll talk about that. You can work it out. But no prices. Just donations. It has to be under $500 so I can claim it as a gift. If it's more than $500, no, can't work that. As much as I'd love to, we're not going to do any formal contract works. No advertising on Facebook. I don't know if Zuckerberg will let me do that and get away with it. All right. Facebook Live. This has been Facebook Live. ADHD. Philosopher. Oh my God, I'm misspelling it. I don't have time. We're wrapping it up. Philosopher. Talk. Show. Pilot. I have no idea what I'm doing at all. No formal training in communications, no experience. Just going by the seat of my pants. All right, it's 2:30, y'all. Let's find an exit. I didn't have an exit song. Well, let's just go back here. Intro, exit.
My mind is clearer now. At last, all too well, I can see where we are.
Oh shit!
If you strip away.
Goodbye, everybody. It's fun.
The man, you will see where we are soon. Started to believe the things they say of you. You really do believe this talk of God is true. And all of what you've done will soon get swept away. You've begun to matter more than the things you say.
All right, Jacob, I'm done. Really good, y'all.